You ever watch a movie, and when the movie ends, you say to yourself, "What the fuck did I just watch?" The Lighthouse. This is a movie that stars Willem Dafoe and Robert Pattinson. This movie came out in October of 2019. It's a psychological horror film with emphasis on psychological. And I didn't catch this in the theater. As a matter of fact, I may have seen the trailers to this, but I wasn't interested in it. They didn't rope me, didn't pull me in. And just to give an overview of the story without spoiling it, although I will tell you details about the film that, well, it's kind of hard to talk about it without spoiling it, but the overview of the story is that Willem Dafoe plays this crabby, cantankerous old man who, I believe, from what I've seen in the story, lives at a lighthouse. He maintains the lighthouse, and every so often, someone comes to assist him in the work. And that person will come and work for him, and then that person will leave, and I assume someone else will come back. But at any rate, Robert Pattinson plays the character who comes to work for him at the lighthouse. When Robert Pattinson's time is up, a big storm hits the island that they're located on, and the ship that dropped him off is unable to pick him up. And that's when things get a little bit interesting, because these two characters are forced to interact with each other. And it's a very odd interaction. This is a movie that, you know, it was directed by the same person who directed the horror film, another psychological horror film called The Witch. Many of you may remember that film. I actually did see that film in the theater. And I think at the time, my review was kind of negative on that movie, but I would like to go back and watch it again, because I feel like I want to give that movie another shot. And maybe it's not as bad as I remember it to be. But at any rate, this movie, it reminds me a whole lot of the movie Eraserhead, where you have things happening in the movie that you just have to sit back, scratch your head, and say, "What the fuck?" Could I recommend this movie? I couldn't. Because at the end of the day, I didn't like the movie. I thought that it was just a really strange and odd movie. Almost an artistic, psychological horror film with more emphasis on psychological and really not much emphasis on horror, because there's really not any horror in this film. There are horrific things that happen, but the characters are so odd in what they experience and what they envision that it really, for me, seemed really over the top at times. And this is a movie that is kind of difficult to talk about at the end of the day, because it is almost like being on an acid trip, where characters do really bizarre things, where they behave strangely in the entire movie. And you know, as a movie watcher, I'm just sitting there like going, "What the fuck is this movie saying?" But you know, as the movie progressed, I mean, there's things in the movie that I'm just sitting there watching it, and I'm thinking, why was this in this film? What purpose does this serve? I mean, you know, as an example, the character that Willem Dafoe plays, he, you know, goes up to the top of the lighthouse to maintain the light. He never allows Robert Pattinson's character to follow him, and whenever he goes, he locks the door behind him, and whenever he comes out, he locks the door so Robert Pattinson's character can't see what's going on. But, you know, then we have scenes where Robert Pattinson's character standing outside looking up at the lighthouse, and he sees Willem Dafoe's character naked and masturbating inside the lighthouse. And then in particular, there's one scene where Robert Pattinson is looking up at Willem Dafoe at the top of the lighthouse, and he's masturbating again. And you have this shot where Pattinson is looking, and you can see the sperm falling through the cracks, passing his head, and almost about to hit him in the head. And I'm just thinking, what the fuck purpose does this serve? And then we have scenes in the movie where Robert Pattinson finds like a porcelain statue of a mermaid that's nude. Of course, I mean, we only see tits. The rest of it is all fish and fins. And he's in his room masturbating while holding the porcelain statue and just... And I'm just like, what the fuck purpose does this serve? Other than to just shock the audience. Because in all honesty, I just don't really believe those scenes served anything. I don't want to see a movie where we see an old fucking man jacking off and then Robert Pattinson jacking off. And I'm just looking at the film. I'm grossed out by the sperm about to drop on the guy's head. And I'm just like, what the fuck, man? What the fuck? So, and then Robert Pattinson's character is seeing all these weird visions. He's seeing tentacles. He's seeing mermaids. And for no apparent reason, this one-eyed seagull just keeps stalking him. He's outside shoveling shit, shoveling coal, making oil, whatever he's doing. This fucking seagull with one eye just keeps fucking stalking him. It'll land by him. It'll just start, you know, screaming at him. I mean, you know, he's always, shoo, get the fuck out of here. What the fuck's up with this bird? And I'm just like, what the fuck is going on in this movie? And we see these two characters, you know, they're really drawn together. Willem Dafoe's character treats Robert Pattinson's character like shit. He makes him do all the shit work. I mean, literally shit work, as he has to dump the shit that Willem Dafoe leaves in a fucking bucket, shit and piss. And I mean, he has to do all the shitty work. Willem Dafoe just treats the man bad. And where I might have sympathy for Robert Pattinson's character, he's so fucking weird that you come off as feeling really no sympathy for any of these fuckers in this film. I mean, we have a scene where, you know, the storm batters the house that they're in. The house gets a little bit flooded. There's water on the floor. Robert Pattinson's drunk off his ass, pissing in the floor, walking in the piss and water. And I'm just like, this is disgusting. And, you know, you ask yourself, what is this guy saying? Is he trying to say, the people behind the movie, what are you trying to say here, dude? It's a movie that, you know, it's just characters saying really weird things, doing really weird things. I guess if you look beneath the surface, what can I say that, you know, this film might have been saying to me? You see two characters, you see a dynamic where there's a power struggle, where Willem Dafoe's character wants to lord over this benevolent character. He wants to enforce his dominance over this character. He wants to piss on this character, show that he's the dominant one, and somehow he gets a freaky thrill out of being pissy and mean to Robert Pattinson's character. So there's a power struggle here. There's a dominant struggle here. It's almost like two dogs vying for dominance. And, you know, Robert Pattinson early on in the film starts really experiencing really strange visions. And I'm just thinking, what's bringing this on? I mean, both men are damaged. And I know I've spoiled certain aspects of the movie. I didn't intend on it, but I tend to do that when a film is just fucking everywhere. But, you know, both men are damaged. Willem Dafoe's character has a hidden secret where he, you know, had someone help him in the lighthouse earlier. And, you know, he tells his story how, you know, they quit, couldn't take it, and left. And we find out later on that he ended up killing the guy. And then Robert Pattinson's character also had a brush with death where in a previous job, one of the people he worked with ended up dying, and he believed he let it happen and he should have did something about it. But so both of these characters are damaged already. And, you know, I believe that there's a metaphor here that, you know, almost gives me, once I think about it, you know, there's a scene in the film at the very end where Robert Pattinson finally asserts his dominance and literally treats Willem Dafoe's character like a dog. Has him in a leash on all fours and literally saying to him, come on dog, be a good dog, you're a good doggy. I mean, leading him around on a leash. And you know, there are some genuine funny moments in the film, but for the most part, you know, we could say psychological, we could say horror, but pretty much the behaviors and just the really weird things that the characters do is off-putting in terms of what they're trying to do in the story, because it doesn't help. To me, it kind of takes you out of it because you're sitting there thinking, what the fuck? But, you know, at the very end of the film, Robert Pattinson's character finally gets the key and goes up into the lighthouse. The only thing up there is the light, you know, that's supposed to let ships know where the rocks are. He sees the light, stares at the light, touches the light, and falls down the stairs of the lighthouse. And immediately I'm watching this, and I kind of drew parallels to Adam and Eve and discovering when they discovered the knowledge of good and evil, and they were cast out. I think that, you know, that whole aspect of the light being at the lighthouse, once he touched it, his eyes were opened in some aspect of the story. He knew what was going on. He saw the truth. And then he was cast out. So I kind of, you know, related it to Adam and Eve. They ate the apple. They learned the truth and the reality of good and evil. And they were cast out. So in some regards, I mean, I think it could be a metaphor for mankind learning the truth and being cast out. And in another term, we could say it's a struggle for dominance. It's a show of the imperfections of man. So there's a lot of things in this movie, but overall, I just feel like, what was the point of the whole thing? Now, that's not to say that there aren't things that I did like about the movie. Now, basically, my likes of this movie are all on a technical level. The cinematography, the look of the movie is simply awesome. The movie takes place in the 1800s, and what you see, and the fact that the movie was filmed black and white, really enforces the story, and it really makes you feel like you're watching events that took place in the 1800s. So, bravo to the filmmakers. Willem Dafoe, the acting that he does is simply awesome. Dafoe has always pretty much been awesome in anything he's been in, and he doesn't fail here. He's totally epic and excellent in bringing this character to life. Robert Pattinson, you see him as kind of a shy, submissive character at the beginning who starts to experience these visions. He starts to go kind of nuts. And, you know, he goes through a whole range of emotions. Great job. I think he did a great job. But I, you know, this is a film that I can honestly say is not going to be for everyone. You're going to like it or you're going to hate it. You're probably not going to just be like, oh, it was okay. And I didn't hate it, but at the same time, I just thought it was just a big bunch of what the fuck. So, you know, take my opinion with a grain of salt, everybody. I would love to hear what you thought about the movie. If you liked it, that's fine. It's just one of those movies that's not for me. I think that it was pretty much a bizarre film. And, you know, if I compare this film to the director's earlier film, The Witch is, in my opinion, much better than this one. This one is just, the only thing I can say about this one is that it tried to be different in what it was doing. But other than that, it was just too much off-the-wall bullshit for me. with weird characters doing weird things and just totally taking me out of the film. So anyway, there you have it, guys. My thoughts on The Lighthouse. Wow. What an experience that was.